Lord of the Rings is based on such a well-loved book. So the responsibility of bringing this world to the screen is obviously enormous. And finally, the technology caught up with the incredible imagination that Tolkien injected into this story of his. And so this is the time. This is the time that this movie can finally be made.
And action!
We began the shoot in 1999. You know, it was the opportunity of a lifetime, especially in New Zealand, where we just don't get to make films of this size. We never, ever have.
There was no expectation. There was no idea of what the movie was going to be.
It was a massive undertaking.
There was a lot of things that we were kind of figuring out as we went along.
Been there, done that.
We were inventing a lot of the technology and the way in which we could use digital tools to tell a story like this.
That was all new territory. We weren't even sure if it was going to work.
I'm not listening.
You know, it was a big rolling adventure. You're holding onto the reins, this thing's completely out of control, but you're just trying to ride it out.
Even looking back on it today, I wonder how the heck we got through all of that work. But we did.
4 years down the line, and finally you've arrived at your official last day.
And cut.
Lovely last shot.
Thank you, too.
You finished it.
50 years from now, the interaction of the characters and the way that Peter has inspired everyone to commit to this story is what will last.
There's not one member of the Fellowship that I don't think I'll know for the rest of my life.
We were doing it together as a force, and in that way, the Fellowship became a reality.
It was made with love, it was made with great care and commitment, and I do genuinely think that that spirit has made its way onto the screen.
They've never before given an Oscar to what they described as a fantasy. Ever. Ever.
Doing three movies with all the complexity and detail that these films have is something I probably will never want to do again in my life. This is the first and only time. 10 years later.
B Mark.
Now we're going back.
We were doing it all over again.
Yes.
Bring me another dwarf.
I'm going on an adventure.
It was a little bit like returning to summer camp. You know, so many of the people who were part of the first journey are part of this journey.
He's back.
We actually shot for 266 days on The Hobbit, which was exactly the same number of days that we shot on The Lord of the Rings. So I've sort of done the once-in-a-lifetime experience twice, but not a third time. There won't be a third time.
So now it's a slightly more well-oiled machine with the same charm and chaotic geniuses behind it.
Pete has such an amazing ability to take on such huge stories on such epic scale.
Slightly scary filming a real dragon.
It's quite weird trying to shoot a dragon that doesn't exist yet. I just kept thinking of Benedict Cumberbatch's face, which is probably not good because it's not going to look like Benedict Cumberbatch.
The Battle of Five Armies is going to be astonishing.
Film three, I'm actually enjoying. I think it's the best of the three. There's a hell of a lot of action. I mean, it's why it's called the Battle of the Five Armies, because it's got a battle in it.
We're going to see a battle unlike any battle committed to film before.
It all became an epic, exhausting few months of our lives.
So we were all battle ready. I know myself, I did maybe 2.5, 3 weeks worth of fighting.
I feel really privileged. I can now be involved in one of those battles, a huge, epic Peter Jackson battle.
I can't wait. We're just going to smash some orc butt.
The other important thing with the battle is to keep the focus on the hero characters, the main characters of the film. I mean, they're the driving force of the battle, really.
What I always like about Peter is that he never has that action stuff and the battle stuff at the expense of drama, and he never has it at the expense of an emotional core.
What has appeared on these screens has never been done by anybody else.
There will be six movies that sit alongside each other. It really is the end of a long journey.
As well as being gloriously entertaining. They'll be a memorable time capsule of the time in which they were made.
Completing these films is better than winning a gold medal at the Olympics.
Making these films was almost walking step by step with our characters as they were on their own quest. And now we're coming to the end of our fellowship.
They went on the journey with us. They went there and back again.
It was a very special experience.
Ooh, that was a journey worth going on, you know?